One of the important points we have picked up is that in the budget, the Reserve Bank Act is likely to get amended, probably as part of the Finance Act itself, and it might get more powers to look at NBFCs. NBFCs anyway are regulated by the Reserve Bank. More importantly, they will get regulatory powers over housing finance companies as well, which at the moment is regulated by the National Housing Bank. Well, what are the lacunas in supervision and regulation of housing finance companies, and what more can be done by the Reserve Bank? We're being joined by two experts, H.R. Khan, former Reserve Bank of India Deputy Governor, and Mr. R.V. Verma, former CMD National Housing Bank. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us. Mr. Khan, first to you. What we are picking up is that regulatory functions of NHB may come over to RBI, not supervisory. You think that's a good idea?
Lata, this is a very old proposal. Maybe, at least to my knowledge, a decade-old proposal. Mm. When the whole issue of RBI selling its equity shares in institutions which it regulates was done, and the entire shareholding was to be transferred to NHB, from NHB to the government, this was there, the proposal. For a long time, this proposal was going to and fro, but it is good that at least there is some thinking, because there is an inherent conflict of...
Yeah, no, pardon? Mr. Khan, I think that has been implemented. No, now the ownership has gone to the government, but
yeah,
it appears...
Yeah.
That's it appears that regulatory powers will come to RBI over housing finance. Yeah, please.
Because there is an inherent conflict of interest between NHB and its refinance and developmental role and its regulatory role. That was the case in the case of NABARD and other, to some extent. It'd be, so that is why the power should be in a separate entity. And RBI is now building up its expertise. And as you know, HFC is a subset of NBFC. So the NBFC, HFC issues are quite overlapping, and they have a lot of linkages with banks. So the bank linkages, banks are being regulated by RBI. I think it makes eminent sense that regulation sits in one place, and it is they have a common pool of experienced and capable pool. And the linkages are, the interlinkages are there. And the recent financial stability report has talked about the solvency-related contagion which can happen from a large NBFC.
Mr. Khan.
Keeping all that, this makes eminent sense that the regulatory power comes to Reserve Bank.
No, Mr. Khan, what
having
I was asking
that,
you
having
is...
Having said that...
No, sir, Mr. Khan, one minute.
That, let me just add one small point.
Yeah,
so we have seen RBI over the years has expertise and in this field. But in case of large NBFCs, particularly CICs, there have been some gaps in terms of both the regulatory and supervisory areas, which RBI is trying to plug. So when this HFC comes, that puts an additional responsibility to on RBI to further fine-tune its regulatory and supervisory capability.
No, I take your point. But before I go to Mr. Verma, I just wanted to ask you, Mr. Khan, should not supervision also of HFCs also come under...
Yes.
Mr. R.V. Verma is also with us. Mr. Verma, your own thoughts on, you know, whether this is enough, and although, as we've been saying, the regulatory powers could go to the RBI, but is it not necessary that supervisory powers also go through? What more do you think is needed?
In fact, Lata, I have my own views on the bifurcation of the regulatory or the transfer of regulatory role to the Reserve Bank of India. If you look at the sector as a whole, you have a holistic view on the sector, then you have to see the background under which the National Housing Bank was created under the NHB Act 1987. And that was essentially to ensure that there is a specialized entity at the apex level to promote housing finance companies and to promote the flow of housing credit into the sector. So with that kind of a role, there was hardly any housing finance company at that point of time. And over a period of about 30 years, things have gone on well. There are a large number of housing finance companies which are already operating. And they have been accessing funding from all sources, including the banking system and the financial institutions and the NHB refinance. And all is well. Now, one episode, I think, should not really make such a huge difference. But I would think that there should be a better coordination between the National Housing Bank and the Reserve Bank of India. And the earlier arrangement that we had, where we had two directors from the RBI board on the board of NHB, that should be restored. One director could be a non-executive director, and the other director should necessarily be an executive director who is in the executive function of the Reserve Bank of India. So earlier we had a deputy governor and another director from the RBI board on the board of NHB. That would essentially, you know, send out a very strong signal and message also to the industry.
Mr. Verma, I must oppose this on the issue that you have RBI directors in all the banks. This really has not helped. One director, you know, who comes once in probably eight times in a year for a board meeting is certainly not equipped to run the institution. And it only gives the Reserve Bank a bad name, because everyone keeps saying, oh, you had a director on the board and still all the mess happened. This putting one director on the board has not proven useful in any instance. So I want to come, Mr. Verma, to the supervision itself. How does NHB supervise the books of housing finance companies? Is it done the way in which RBI does the annual inspection of the books of banks? Do you have a cadre like that?
You're talking about banks or the NBFCs?
I'm asking you if NHB does a line-by-line inspection of the books of housing finance companies. After all, RBI does inspect the books of banks. On similar lines, do you have a cadre, do you have a department in NHB which supervises the books of NHBs, housing finance companies?
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. So there is a very elaborate system of both regulating and supervising the housing finance companies on-site and off-site. Mm-hmm. And there is also a growing move towards risk-based supervision, where we feel that if certain housing finance company is big enough and it requires more close scrutiny and monitoring, that happens, and the resources are diverted, or rather, focused on those kinds of housing finance companies. So there is adequate infrastructure, there is adequate provision under the NHB Act to ensure that the HFCs are a well-regulated body. And so far, with now about 100 housing finance companies, we haven't seen any housing finance company go under. I'm comparing housing finance companies with NBFCs. With banks, it's a little different, but as far as the RBI in taking over the role of the supervision of HFCs is aligning itself to the RBI's role of supervision over NBFCs, which is very light touch, and I don't think there'll be a focused dedicated team for inspecting or looking at the housing finance company. It requires a different kind of skill set. It requires a different approach, an insight into the housing sector overall, which is very, very important. So the real side of the real sector of the economy is very important to have insight into, for being able to more efficiently and effectively regulate the financial sector part of it.
Okay.
That integration and holistic approach is very, very important. But yes, now if you look at the conflict of interest issue with the ownership with the Government of India and regulation is transferred to the Reserve Bank of India, it's possible, provided there is sufficient and adequate regulation of the housing finance companies, and should not be mixed with the larger set of 12,000 NBFCs. That can be fraught with risk.
Okay.
And the housing finance companies, the kind of business that they do, is very different from the NBFCs. NBFCs have more diversified portfolio. HFCs are more concentrated portfolio.
Yeah.
So the risk is more concentrated, requires a different kind of skill set.
Yeah, take your point.
Kind of approach.
Yeah. Mr. Khan, you want to react to that?
No. Raj Vikas is a good friend of mine. We often agree to disagree.
Okay.
So I was also on the board of NHB. What the points he has made, he has some valid points he has made. But let me just add some additional points. In NBFC sector, there are different, whether it's asset financing, loan companies, GICs, account aggregators. So there are variety of NBFC sector. So it is not that it is one price fit all. So RBI does look after different categories of NBFC. So HFC will be another category.
Okay.
And I absolutely agree there has to be coordination between, because NHB needs to get insights into that, coordination between RBI and NHB, and there is a coordination mechanism through FSTC.
Mm-hmm.
So getting insights into the sector, but regulating and supervising, I think we need not mix up that. We can get all insights, but regulation and supervision, there will be inherent conflict of interest and developing expertise. And point I mentioned about interlinkages between banks and HFC is a large chunk of that. And the other point which Mr. Verma mentioned, that there has been no failure, no bank has gone under. I think the recent developments indicate the sector is under serious...
I think this requires...
Partly because of the whole business model itself is now coming into question. So we what was happening some time back, we did not think that things are same as they were earlier. Recent times indicate there has been serious.
No, I agree this requires...
And the other point, the housing finance are not purely mortgage financing. Large chunk is
builder finance.
Non-mortgage finance.
Yes, yes, and absolutely. Now, I was coming to that.
So these are the new trends we need to keep in mind.
I agree with that. We need a sit-down discussion with both of you on camera, where you could agree to disagree. Thank you very much, Mr. Khan and Mr. Verma. There is, of course, a niggling worry in the markets that there has been a whole host of revamping, restructuring of builder loans, and the NHB has not been able to control that. So there is a worry that greater supervision, greater rigor is needed. But that discussion on a later day, it looks like some changes are on the way.
Okay, well, for the markets, it's picked up quite a bit of pace. The Nifty is up about 0.3%. With that, it's a wrap on Bazaar. But lots of trading ideas lined up in just moments from now.